welcome to a new episode of In Peace Stories. Our story today will be focused on the madrasa. Madrasa, what is madrasa? Madrasa is a system of religious education that exists in the Muslim world. It is distinguished in the way that they focus their education on the Islamic and religious dimensions. But in some countries in the Muslim world, those madrasas also combine the regular curriculum and education of the country along with the religious education. In this way, they become similar to what you can say, for example, the Catholic schools in the United States or Jewish schools that have a focus on the religion and also on the national curriculum. And some of them focus only on the religious issues and they don't focus on the national curriculum as well. And they vary from country to country. So my research in 2004 was focused on the madrasa system. And by the way, the word madrasa is the Arabic word for school. But in non-Arabic speaking Muslim countries, the word madrasa in Arabic is reserved for religious education systems, while the word school in English is reserved for the regular school systems. So our research was mandated by the US State Department and the USAID. And they wanted to see if they should support the madrasa system in Bangladesh as much as they are supporting the regular national educational system. They have been supporting the national educational system for quite some time, and they realized that the madrasa system in Bangladesh actually absorbs maybe 40% or more of all the students of the country, boys and girls. So they wanted to see to what extent they should support the madrasas as much as they are supporting schools or not. And of course, in the back of their mind, they are concerned about all the media at that time in 2004 that was talking about the madrasas in Afghanistan and in Pakistan that are breeding violence and terrorism and so on. So they wanted to be cautious, of course, should they support such madrasas or not. So our research was to just understand what's going on with those madrasas and what kind of education, what kind of students and teachers, and is there really a reason or potential for the U.S. Government to support the madrasa as much as they support national education. So we go to Bangladesh, and I, as usual, hired six young people to work with me on the research project. And they were all grads of madrasa, and that helped me to have good insight into the content and also access to some of those madrasas, given that they are such conservative places. And they wouldn't necessarily be that open to someone coming from outside to try to understand about them. And we went there and we designed a good research model, and we decided to do the research in four different regions of Bangladesh, in Dhaka, Jessore, Sylhet, and Chittagong. And after doing Dhaka, I went to Chittagong with a group of the researchers, and we wanted to do a survey in different madrasas that work with boys, work with girls, in the city, in the rural areas, and so on. One madrasa was highly recommended for us to go to was in the rural areas of Chittagong, about 2 hours away from Chittagong itself. And that madrasa was unique because it had two sections. There was a section for boys and a section for girls. And what was even more unique is that the girl section had about 800 plus students, K-12. And they were all girls, of course. But also all the teachers and the principal and everyone working in the madrasa was a woman, which was unique. It was the only madrasa in Bangladesh that was fully women from A to Z. So we went to do the research in that madrasa. I go there and I meet with the students, like you see in this picture. And also, of course, we meet with the professors or the teachers and the principal. And as you can see from the images of the teachers and the students, a very conservative place, as expected of such religious educational settings in Bangladesh. And we spoke about the madrasa and how they're doing their work and what are the issues they are facing and dealing with. And of course, one question I had was, what do you need to make things better for your madrasa and for the girls? And I will let the viewers take a few seconds to think or guess what do you think was the first thing that those teachers and the principals said that they wanted as a priority to make things better for the girls and for their madrasa. If you like to guess, please write a comment as you're watching this video in the comment section. And we'll see what we will get. But however, I have to say that the responses were among the biggest surprises I had in all my research work in my life. The first thing they said that they wanted for the madrasa and for the girls was a basketball court. Yep, a basketball court. That was the first thing they wanted. And they said, our girls have energy, and they are young, and we need to give them a space to get vent out that energy in a positive way. And they need us sports. So we want to have a basketball court for them that will help them greatly and help the madrasa greatly. I said, wow, this is really great. What else? They said, we also want musical instruments. Yes, musical instruments. And again, they emphasized how the girls are creative and some are really artistic, and we need to give them the space to express themselves. I have to say, I was very surprised. I thought they would say, give us more books, more computers, more religious books. But no, they knew what those girls want. And I have to say that I was very impressed by the teachers and the principal. They all, even though they were so covered and so conservative in the way they appear, but they all had very good degrees in education, and some had master's degree in education. And also, they spoke English fairly well. So obviously, they were in tune, and they knew what is needed. It was quite a surprise, actually, and I have to say that the entire research and madrasa system in Bangladesh showed us that they varied. Some madrasas were very promising, and they have done so much for their kids and for their communities. And some madrasas were still lagging behind, indeed, and perhaps not advancing the children as much as they should. Our report, I think, was balanced, and it showed both. But it showed that there is promise. It showed that the madrasas are not as bad as the media portrays them. Whether in Bangladesh or in other places in the world. And that there is a space where there can be support for those madrasas. And I have to say, I was very pleased that after we published our report and it was received by USAID and the State Department, I actually was called to a meeting in the State Department in Washington, D.C. to speak to some of the directors about the findings. And they were very surprised by some of the positive findings. And they directly asked the question, so do you think that we should support madrasas? And I said, some of them definitely are worthy of support. I was very happy later to learn that the U.S. government, after this, they actually granted 40 scholarships to 20 boys, 20 girls every year in the American Cultural Center in Dhaka for the students to learn English. They sent teachers of madrasas to the United States to learn about the educational system on that three-week tours that they do for many teachers from all over the world. They even give a bus to one madrasa so that they can transport the children back and forth. And they continue to have a healthy relationship with some of the madrasas that we identified as positive models and promising models. The points I want to make from this story are two. One is assumptions. Let's not jump with assumptions. Only because we see people dressed in a certain way or conservative madrasas, we need to keep our assumptions out and do the research and let the data speak to us. Let people tell us what they want and what's important for them. It was quite a surprise, and it was very positive to hear good things from such teachers in that research in that girl madrasa. And second, our research can make a difference. We can have an impact. And what we succeeded in doing with this research and the impact we had on the State Department and USAID to the point that they support madrasas and support the girls and boys to learn English and send them on scholarships to the United States. All these are very promising results that could have happened only because we did research with good conviction that we can make a difference. And I am very pleased also to know that many of the researchers who participated with us for 16 years ago and some of the students we met in our work, that research impacted them significantly. Many of them went on to get their PhD from overseas. Many of them are continuing to do their doctorate. Many of them have great jobs in education all over the world. And it shows again that we can make a difference, not only in terms of what we write and the reports and the findings, but also impacting the people who take part in such research. It is one of the highlights of the research work I have done in related to issues of peace and conflict resolution in the wider sense, in this case with a focus on education. And I hope that you found that story useful and helpful. And until more stories, in peace. Amen.